chats with Gabby. How do you lose fat without losing muscle?
I love this question because this should be your goal if you're trying to burn body fat. Your goal should not be lose body fat and then whatever else happens is all good.
Yeah.
Your goal should be lose body fat, preserve muscle, or in really, really perfect situations, gain muscle. Now, why would you want that? If you keep your muscle, you're less likely to have the negative metabolism adaptation. What I mean by that is when you lose weight and lose muscle, metabolism starts to slow down, which makes further weight loss or further fat loss more difficult. Mm-hmm. It also makes the fat loss that you did get more difficult to maintain. So you want to keep muscle because it helps promote a faster metabolism, which means you burn more calories all the time.
And it's protective. I mean, like, you get more strength from it, but they're finding through those studies too about, you know, the immune system and everything else, like how protective it is to acquire more muscle tissue. Yep.
This is also why it's very important that you build the metabolism up, right, by increasing calories before you decide to go in a cut. Because if you get a client who is only eating 1,800 or 2,000 calories, and they have a long way to go fat loss wise, and they come to you and they want to do that, and then you dramatically cut them to, say, and that's not dramatic, they're at 1,800, 1,500 is not dramatic at all, so you cut them down to 1,500 or 1,400 calories, what ends up happening is, sure, they might lose body fat, but that's not enough calories to support the muscle that they need on their body mm-hmm. either. So you end up losing both muscle and body fat at the same time, and then that's where you see someone who loses, and this used to happen a lot. I remember when I used to have the hydrostatic weigh come to the gym all the time, and we'd have them do all of our clients that are our trainers were training. And you'd get trainers, and it would happen a lot, especially when they're a newer trainer and they haven't learned this lesson yet. They'd have a client that they, you know, threw on cardio, cut their calories like crazy, and, you know, they lost them 15, 20 pounds. And so the client's celebrating, they're celebrating, like they did a great job. Then they go do the hydrostatic weigh, and then the person comes back with a higher body fat percentage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they go, and they're like,
I lost weight?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then the client's like, this has got to be wrong. The trainer's questioning if the hydrostatic weigh is correct or not. No, it is. And that's what happens when you cut too hard and you're not at a good sustainable place calorie-wise. You're not feeding the body enough nutrients to hang on to the muscle mass that you have, and you're telling the body to adapt to a lower calorie. So it pares down muscle. It says, okay, it's too expensive to keep this muscle mass on my body because they're feeding it so low of calories that, yeah, sure, it does use and burn fat as fuel because you're not giving it very much fuel, but then it also pairs down muscle because you're not feeding enough nutrients.
It's 100% the reason why you lose muscle when you diet is because your body's purposely trying to slow down its metabolism. It's purposely trying to run on less calories because you're feeding it less calories. Now, this happens almost every time. What I mean by that is almost every time you cut your calories, your metabolism starts to try to slow down a little bit. It's a normal adaptation. Nothing necessarily wrong with it. But again, if it happens too much, you put yourself in a bad situation. Now, how do you prevent this from happening? Well, the number one thing you do is you lift weights. Mm-hmm. And you lift weights in ways that promote muscle growth and strength. So what I mean by that is you don't lift weights in ways to burn tons of calories. So if I'm lifting weights and I'm just going, doing, you know, tons of circuits and going from one exercise to the other because I want to burn body fat. I just want to burn tons of calories. You are sending somewhat of a muscle building signal, but not a super loud one. The best thing to do is to build muscle and build strength, or try to, while cutting your calories. Because what this does is it tells the body, okay, we're not getting enough calories. We need to burn fat for fuel. Wait, should we pare down muscle? No. We need this muscle because we're getting a strong signal from actions that we need muscle mm-hmm. and we need strength. By the way, studies are clear on this. When people diet without exercise, it's about half muscle that they lose. When they lose 10 pounds, it's usually around 5 pounds of muscle, 5 pounds of body fat. This is exactly what will happen if you don't lift weights properly while you're cutting your calories.
You know, this question reminds me of a great conversation that we had with our good buddy Jason Phillips. In fact, this is when we really hit it off with him, is when he did such a good job on that episode that we interviewed him of explaining this and how common it is. Mm-hmm. And honestly, a lot of coaches aren't privy or aren't savvy to coach through this or know what to do. And that's one of the things I love about NCI is that this is one of the most important things that Jason tries to teach to all of his coaches underneath him. And when we had that episode with him, we went deep into this conversation. Mm-hmm. So if you're listening to this and you have more questions and you want more detail, refer back to that episode that we did with Jason Phillips and check out NCI, because this is something that they speak to a lot, and they help coaches and trainers figure this piece out, which I think was one of the more challenging things for me, because most of my career, that's what I was teaching other trainers. Yeah. And then this is what would happen. They would cut their clients, and then they would see the body fat percentage go up, and I'd have to constantly be reminding them mm-hmm. that, you know, you got to take this a lot slower, more methodical approach, because, you know, now we have the tools to be able to check and pay attention to that. In the past, before all these tools existed, you would think that you were a successful trainer. Client lost 20 pounds. They came in, that's what they want to do. They want to lose 20 pounds. But if you made them fatter, you weren't that was successful. And people, that doesn't
constantly be in their ear reassuring them this is the right approach.
And that doesn't compute to the average person. We just talked about like learning to communicate this, right? Like you say that to an average person that, wait a second, how can I lose 20 pounds on the scale but get fatter? Well, it's because you didn't technically add fat to the body. You have a higher percentage of fat.
Because you lost muscle.
Because you lost more muscle than you actually lost body
fat. Right, so 10 pounds of body fat on a 100-pound person is 10% body fat. 8 pounds of body fat on a 70-pound person is a higher body fat percentage, even though there's still less fat because there's less lean mass overall. Here's the second thing you need to do if you want to prevent losing muscle. Eat a high protein diet. So even though you're in a calorie deficit, you still want a higher percentage of your calories coming from protein. Studies are consistent on this. A high protein diet reduces the amount of muscle that's lost in diet. And when you lift, when you diet, and when you lift weights along with the high protein, then the odds are higher that you might actually even build muscle. So number one, lift weights to build muscle, build strength while you're on your calorie deficit. Number two, eat a high protein diet. That'll help a lot. And here's number three. I don't think it's a good idea to go too extreme in fat or carb cutting. In my experience, flattening out carbs, going zero carbs, unless it's helping you health-wise and you have food intolerance, stuff like that, going too low of carbs, in my experience with clients, over time starts to reduce the ability to build muscle, even preserve muscle. Now, studies aren't clear on this. They don't necessarily support this. This is just my own personal experience. I don't have anything wrong with low-carb diets necessarily, but if they're too low for too long, I have seen people start to lose muscle.
Well, and the behavior of that, too, when you go re-